It is anticipated that there is going to be power outages, so folks have an opportunity to plan for that now. You still have time to make the preparations and put your plan in place today, but that time is running out. This storm, I think, as you know, is basically in the area of Cuba and the Yucatan Peninsula. It's moving past that, and then it's going to have pretty much a clear runway in the Gulf of Mexico. We, of course, began preparing over the weekend. On Monday, I signed an executive order. We now have 61 of Florida's 67 counties that are in a state of emergency, and it's been able to help surge resources and help with preparations there. We did get a partial approval of our pre-landfall emergency declaration from FEMA, but we didn't get approved for what we think we need to get approved for. So we're going to go back and try to get a more robust approval there. We are going to have a significant impact from this storm. It's a tropical storm now. It is going to become a hurricane. The models vary on how intense, but there's clearly a pathway for this to rapidly intensify prior to making landfall. You'll see these cones that get produced by the National Hurricane Center. You see these spaghetti models that get put out that I see online, and that's fine, and you should look at that, but just understand this is a very big storm. You're gonna have impacts that are far outside of what a spaghetti model would have or what a cone would have.